Hi everyone, welcome back to another session of Core Java Tutorials. In this session, we are going to look into a Java program. So that is how to use command line arguments. So I'll be showing certain programs on how to give arguments to your main method. So this is the program. So write Java program to demonstrate command line arguments. So let us get started. To make you understand what are command line arguments, let me give you an example. So you can see a notepad here. So this is the shortcut of the notepad, which is there on the desktop. So what will happen if I click on it? Okay, so I'll just double click on it so that it opens, and I'll show you what happens. So as I open it, so you can see that I got some untitled notepad open here, and you need to type something over here and then save it and do your work. So the point here is, as I clicked on it, like I got some untitled notepad. So the basic .exe, notepad.exe file have been executed. So for example, every time I open the notepad, I want some other file to be open. So maybe I have created a notepad file, and I want this to open whenever. So for example, so just to take a look at this particular file over here, so which is a text file. So whenever I open, so let me open this and show you. So this is welcome.txt. So wherein I have given, hi, welcome to Java by Sudha class. And so whenever I open notepad, by default, I want this welcome .txt to open. So to do that, what I can do is I can go to notepad.exe and then give this welcome.txt as command line argument, as one of the argument to the .exe file. Okay. So let me take the path of this welcome. So the path is this welcome.txt. So the name of the file is welcome, and it's a text file, .txt file. And this is there in C drive. So I'm taking this location. So I'm taking this path. So, okay. Now what I need to do is, now I came back to this notepad. I'm clicking on the properties. So I went to properties, and you can see that, let me clear this one, annotations. Okay. So as you have come over here, so you can see this target over here. And this is notepad.exe file, so it's an application, so which is running here. Okay, so the target is this. Now what I need to do is, if I want by default the welcome file to open, so after this notepad.exe, so this is the file that is opening, right? Executable file this is. So this is an exe file, so which is executing. So I need to give a space, and now I'm passing some command line arguments. So what is that argument? So I want it to open every time you are opening notepad. I want it to open this welcome file. Okay. So that's wherein I'm giving the path, and the name of the file is welcome. So I'm saying welcome.txt. Okay. So this is what I have done. So this is the program. So this is the executable program. So I'm executing this program. So while execution, I'm passing this path of this particular welcome file as command line argument. So now after I save it, now let us again look into what will happen when I click on the notepad. So when I clicked on the notepad, you can see by default, it is opening the welcome file. Okay, so I'm closing it. I'm opening it one more time. So you can see that this welcome file is opening for me. Okay, so this is what is called as command line arguments. Command line arguments are passed into the main method in Java, and the command line arguments tell the program how it should operate, and command line arguments will give the power to the programmers to control the program from outside. Okay, so command line arguments are given during invocation of the program itself, and we can pass these arguments into the main method. So command line arguments are useful if you want to customize your program, your Java program with specific values. It is useful for that. Not only for that, command line arguments are also extremely useful when used in batch files and login scripts, as they allow you to create very complex tasks. Okay, so you can very complex tasks can be performed in a simple way by using command line arguments. So this is regarding your command line arguments, or the basic introduction of command line arguments. And now I will show you how to create command line arguments, how to write and how to execute the command line arguments. So let me take the notepad to write my Java program. So I'll clear up all this. Okay, I don't want welcome file to open. So I'm clicking on the notepad. So this is the notepad. So herein I'll be typing my program. So first thing I need to do is I need to give my class. So class, so the name of the class, whatever it is. So I said class, and then the name of the class is CLE, command line arguments. I have taken it in this manner. And inside the class, so I need to give the public static void main. So I'm writing public static void main. So to the main method, we'll be passing the command line arguments. So which is the main will be taking a string of string array. So as an argument, so you can see string args. So why your main method will take only strings is because string is the most common object that is used during applications. So that's the reason why string is taking, why main method is taking string args. And the next reason is you can convert the string into integers. You can also convert string into boolean, float and all that. So conversion of a string into the numerical data types is also possible. And most common used object in any of the Java applications are string object. So that's the reason main method is taking a string array over here. Okay, fine. This is my basic skeleton of the program. So class CLA, so this is the name of the class and this is my main method. And whatever I want, I will be writing inside this main method, and the command lines are taken into this particular string array. Okay, right. So herein, I'll be showing you a program which will read the command line arguments and print the command line arguments one after the other. So for that, I'm taking a for loop. So you know that for loop will be having an initialization of the looping variable. So here the looping variable is I. So I have initialized it to zero, meaning that zero is the first command line argument that I'm taking. So I can give how many ever command line arguments I can. So I'll be taking the length, the count of the command line arguments that I have given with this particular syntax. So which is args.length. Args is the name of the object. And length is a method which is used to actually get the count of the arguments. Okay, so length is used to get the count of an array. Okay, so the number of elements in an array. So args.length. And then I'm incrementing the I because I have started it with the zero. So I'm incrementing it. Okay, fine. So here I'm giving less than. Do not forget, I have given less than. I have not given less than or equal to, because we know that array indexing always starts with a zero. So here also the command lines, command line argument starts with the zero. So that's the reason why we are giving less than. If you give less than or equal to, what will happen is like it will give you array out of index. Okay, so index bound error you'll be getting. So inside this for, since I'm just having one statement, I'm not giving an open bracket and close bracket. So here I'm say I just print the arguments, that's it. Okay. So I said system.out.println, and the arguments are given. This is the name of the array, so args, and then I'll be taking in one by one argument, and then I'm printing on the console. Okay, so that's it. A very, very simple program. So the arguments are taken in args array, So I'm taking the length of this array by using this length function over here, args.length, and then I am incrementing it. Okay, so I'm taking a looping variable I is equal to 0, so which will be initializing the I to 0. So args 0 means the first argument, arg 1 is the second argument, arg 2 is the third argument, and so on till how many other arguments are there, till then the loop will iterate. And after the arguments are exhausted, then the loop will break and come to the next line. So there is no next line. So it will end the program. So I'm saving this file. So save as, I'm saving it on the desktop, and I'm naming it as cla.java. Okay, so I have named it. So you can see that the name of the file have changed over here. So you can just make an observation. Okay, so it is CLA. Okay, so CLA is the name of the file. So now I'm closing the file, and you can see that the file have come up on the desktop. I have saved it on the desktop. So you can see that CLA.java is here. Now I need to execute it. So let me show you how to execute it. To execute it, I need to go to the command prompt. So you can see that command prompt is here. So this is my command prompt, but I need to bring it to this particular file path, okay? So which is desktop. So I'm saying cd desktop. So which comes to this particular desktop. On this desktop, you have this CLA. So now you can execute it. So I'm compiling it. So to compile it, I'll be saying javac.cla.java. So you can find, you can see here that there are no errors. Okay. So you can see that there are no errors. So it just, if there are errors, it will show me the errors over here. So there are no errors. Okay. So that's why I just got the prompt name. So now what I need to do is I need to execute it. To execute it, normally what we do is we'll say Java and then CLA, that's it, right? But here it is not the case. How you need to execute is, you need to execute during execution itself, during the invocation of the program itself, you'll be giving the command lines, okay? So I'm giving a space after this class name. Okay, CLA, and then I'm giving my commands. Okay, so I gave 20, then I said Sudha, then I'm saying Java, then I gave 55, then I'm saying lab program. Okay, so it's a program. So whatever I want, I can give. I can also give float values. I can also say true. And okay, so I can also give a single character. So all this is possible. So all these are, all these that I have given here are the command line arguments, okay? During the execution itself, I have given. So 20 is one argument, Sudha is one argument, Java is one argument, and you can see each and every argument is separated by a space over here, okay? 55 is an argument, lab is an argument. So you can give how many other arguments you want, you can give. So now I'll click on enter and we'll see what will happen. So as I click on enter, so you can make the output, you can see the output over here. So the output, it is clearly giving each and every argument. Okay, so 20 is the first argument, so which is at 0, and then Sudha, and then Java, and you can see all the characters, all the arguments that we have given are taken into the loop. So the size of that args.length, right? So which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So I have given 10. So this is args.length. And then the loop is iterating from 0 to 9. So I have given that, right? If I give less than or equal to, so what will happen? So let me show you that what will happen. So say, for example, I have given... I have given less than or equal to, okay? So less than or equal to, so I'm saving it. So save it, close it, go to command prompt, okay? So now I'm compiling it. So I said Java C, and then the name of the file is cla.java. So it will execute because it's a runtime error. So now say, for example, I said Java and then CLA, and then I said 20 and 30 and 40. So I have given three arguments. And now you can see that. So it is printing 20, 30 and 40 for me. And also it have given an exception. So what is that exception? So which is array index out of bounds exception. Because there is the loop is iterating. Arcs length is 3, right? But this is at 0 position, this is 1 at 1, and this is at 2. But you are iterating for 3 also, okay? Because you have given less than or equal to 3. So this condition satisfies and there is no third argument. So it has gone out of bounds. So this is arcs is an array, right? So string array. So array index out of bounds exception you have got. So take care while writing your loop, especially when you're navigating through an array. So this is one of the programs. So let me show you another program wherein I'm taking the value into the program as a command line argument, and then I'll find out the factorial of the number. Okay. So the name of the program is, so I'll take the notepad again. So the name of the program, so what is the name of the program? Compute factorial of a number, factorial of a number given as command line argument. Okay, so I'm taking the command line argument, and I want to take a number through command line argument and compute the factorial. So I'll show you that. So the class is CLA. So let me say it is fact. Okay. So I have taken it. And so let me write this public static void main. String args. Okay, so now int n is equal to, so here the point is I should not write scanner class and all that because I'm taking it through the command line arguments. But make an observation that the command line argument is a string. Now how can you convert this string argument into an integer? So you do have a procedure to do that. So you have a method which is called as parseInt method. So parseInt method, parseInt. Okay, so parseInt method is there in the integer class, which will actually convert the string into integer. Okay, so you just need to pass the string as a parameter into this parseInt method. So it is nothing but args 0, so which is args 0. So this args 0, you are passing it into parseInt. Okay. But this again will not work because parseInt is a static method and you need to call it with the name of the class. So the name of the class is integer, so which is integer. So integer.parseInt, and you're passing this argument, which is nothing but n value or the number, given number, and you're converting this string into integer over here. So this number will be converted into unsigned or signed integers. Okay, fine. So now n will get the integer value of the argument. So after that, your logic is same, like how you compute the factorial. So you just do that. So I said fact is equal to 1. So I'm taking a for loop. So I'm iterating the for loop, int I is equal to 1. So I said I is less than or equal to so n, right? Okay, so I plus plus. Okay, so this is my logic. So factorial of n means that n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 and so on till 1. So I'm iterating like that, 1 into 2 into 3 into so on till n. Okay, so I'm iterating it in this way. Okay, so now I said fact is equal to fact into, so which is I. Okay, so I will take one first, then it will take two, then it will take three and four, so on till n. Okay, so that is nothing but factorial. So I'm printing the factorial by using the system.out.println. So the factorial of, so I'll put the double quotes here, put the plus here, an n, and then a plus, and then, so I just want my output factorial of n is, right? Okay, so is, okay, now plus, and the result is there in fact. So I'm giving factorial here. So that's it, very simple program. So wherein I'm taking an string argument, convert it into integer and perform the factorial. So let me save this, and the name of the program is fact, right? So I'll say fact.jar, and I'm saving it on the desktop. Okay, right. So as I did it, so you can see that fact.java have come over here. Now let me take the command prompt. Inside the command prompt, let me execute the program. So by using Java C fact.jar. Okay. So you can see that there are no errors. So it is asking me to execute. So let me execute and show you. Okay, right. So I have to say Java, and the name of the class is fact, and a space, and I'm giving 5. Okay, so I want 5. I'm passing 5 as a command line. But this 5 here is nothing but a string. But inside the program, I have converted this string into integer. So as I execute, you can see the factorial of 5 is 1. So I can find factorial of any number. So if I give 10, you can see the factorial of 10 is this one. Okay. So instead of hard coding, you can actually pass the values to the command line arguments into your main method. Okay. That's it, friends. This is how you pass arguments into your main method during the execution of the program. Hope this video is helpful to you. Thank you.